Hey guys, welcome to another Warframe video, and today we're going to take a quick look at the newest weapon that has just been added into the game via Barakateer, the Prisma Twin Gremlins. Now, this is only on PC at the moment, because when it comes to Barakateer, consoles are a few rotations behind, and even on PC, Barakateer has already departed, so the only way to get it is to either wait for him to bring it back or to buy it from another player. Now, the Prisma Twin Gremlins are fully automatic secondary nail guns that require you to be at least Mastery Rank 11 to use them. They do 27 damage per shot, which is actually substantially lower than the original Twin Gremlins, which did 36.99, and the damage distribution is 12.7 as puncture, 11.3 as slash, and only 3 as impact. This is where most of the damage difference comes from, because the original Twin Gremlins had an equal amount of slash, puncture, and impact. Luckily though, the supporting stats are a lot better. The accuracy is higher at 36.4 as opposed to 16.7. The crit chance is 23%, whereas on the originals it was only 15. They have a higher crit multiplier of 1.9 versus the originals 1.5. They also possess a much higher magazine that has 70 rounds, whereas the original only had 30. They have faster reload of 0.9 versus the originals 1.1, and higher status chance of 23%, whereas the original only had 15. And all of this absolutely overpowers the decrease in damage. These are much stronger than the original Twin Gremlins. They also come with 1V polarity as standard, which is always nice. Now, the setup I ended up with on the Twin Gremlins is a 3 Forma build where I've added 3 Vs, and it's a hybrid with hydraulic crosshairs. So I'm running Hornet Strike for damage, Barrel Diffusion for multi-shot, Lethal Torrent for fire rate and multi-shot, Prime Pistol Gambit for crit chance, Prime Target Cracker for crit damage, and then Hydraulic Crosshairs for even more crit chance on a headshot. And I did this because the crit chance, even with Prime Pistol Gambit, is only 66%, so I wanted the weapon to be a little bit more reliable when it came to crits. And I topped it all off with Pistol Pestilence and Jolt for corrosive damage and a decent amount of status. Now, this setup is just amazing versus armor, because on top of critting a lot and doing a lot of damage with puncture and slash procs, it procs corrosive a lot. It's just the benefit of dropping thermite rounds for hydraulic crosshairs, you don't get those heat procs. So for armor, this setup is just awesome. The same can be said for the infested. The damage is just way too much for them to take, and you can see that even level 100 ancient healers melt in under a second. But then we run into the corpus, where you kind of want to play around with different elemental combos. Because corrosive on a weapon that doesn't have a lot of impact to begin with is no bueno versus shields. It's not terrible, it will get the job done, but if I were to take this into a corpus sortie, I would probably switch the corrosive over to gas. That way, the toxin procs inflicted by the gas cloud will bypass those shields instead of you trying to punch through them a little bit at a time. But that's only for sorties, and high-level sorties at that. If you're doing a normal corpus mission, the corrosive combo is gonna be just fine. So what do I think about the Prisma Twin Gremlins? Well, I like them a lot. They're just really fun to use, and the damage isn't too shabby either, they're pretty strong. The only issue I can see people having with these is that they are not hit-scanned. They fire actual bolts, so they have travel time and you have to lead the target. But, on the other hand, this also means that you can pin enemies to walls, which is always fun. They're just awesome in every way, shape or form. They look awesome, they sound awesome, they have a pretty good reload animation, they do good damage with good crit chance, good crit multiplier, good status chance, very fast reload, they have a big magazine and a big ammo reserve as well. And, at the moment at least, they have a very high Riven disposition. Some of the Rivens that people have sent me for these were absolutely insane. So if you're one of the lucky few and you have a Riven for the Twin Gremlins, I would roll it a little bit, because you could end up with a very powerful set of nail guns. So yeah, the Prisma Twin Gremlins are actually really good, and I would highly recommend you pick them up once you have the opportunity. And as always, I thank you very much for watching, I hope you have enjoyed the video, and I will see you next time. Bye bye.